Hallelujah. God is good. Our God is awesome. He is the King of Kings. He is the only wise God. He is the one that thinks good thoughts towards us. We cannot do anything without God. Just celebrate this God wherever you are, because He is worthy to be praised. He is the King of Kings. He is the El Shaddai. He is the Elohim. He is the God that has good and beautiful, wonderful thoughts towards His children. Our God is faithful and always faithful. And so, Heavenly Father, we bless you. We worship you because you are God. There is none like unto thee. You deserve all the glory and all the honor. We have come at this moment to hear your word. Use me, my Father. Let my tongue give life and healing. Use me as a pen of red writer to speak your word. Holy Spirit, I welcome you. Thank you for my viewers. Circumcise our hearts, O God. Thank you, my Father. For in Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen. God bless you, beautiful people of God. Welcome to our moments with the Lord. Is your friend and sister, Sister Isioma Uche. How are you? How is your family? Be still and know that God is God. Today, by the grace of God, we'll be speaking on a topic that says, the mind of God towards humanity. You can personalize it to yourself. You can be a prophet to yourself. You can say to yourself, the mind of God towards me. Hallelujah. Generally, when we talk about mind, the first word that comes into us is the ability for a person to think, the thought of a person, the plan of a person. Now, what is God's mind towards us, or what are God's mind towards us? Let's see God's mind towards us. God's mind simply means God's thoughts, God's plan, His wishes, His program, His agendas, desire, purpose towards humanity. This means that God's plans towards humanity, that is what we are going to be talking about today. Now, before, without wasting our time, let's see what the plans of God towards us are. Most time I've heard people saying, it's like God does not think good things towards them anymore. It's like everything about them is finished. They just look at themselves and say, oh God, am I the worst sinner on earth? Oh God, what have I done to deserve this evil? Oh God, have you forgotten me? Oh God, are you still the one that creates me? And you just allow this trauma, difficulties, situation to befall them. Now let's see what are God's plan towards us. We can take our reading together. Let's travel to the book of Jeremiah chapter 29 verses 11. Jeremiah chapter 29 verses 11. Hallelujah. God is speaking. For I know the thoughts that I think. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Now, this is the Lord speaking. Jeremiah is just a vessel passing what God has said to us. This is not like a dream that Jeremiah was dreaming. And Jeremiah began to say, this is what God said to him. But this time, God is saying, this is His thoughts for us. He said, the thoughts of peace and not of evil to give you an expected end. Hallelujah. God says, the thoughts He has towards humanity, The thought he has for you, the thought he has for me, the thought he has for the nations of the world, they are all thoughts of good and not of evil, to give us an expected end, to give us a destined purpose, to produce good results. This means that all thoughts of good for us are perfect thoughts. God has perfect thoughts towards us. He has wonderful thoughts. He has glorious thoughts. He has lovely thoughts. He has excellent thoughts towards us. Hallelujah. Let's see what the psalmist also tells us. The psalmist, what he tells us in the book of Psalm 139, verses 17 to 18. It says, how precious also are the thoughts unto me, O God. He said, how wonderful, how glorious, how beautiful, how good are the thoughts that you have towards me, O God. How great is the sum of them. The psalmist says, how great is the sum. When I added all the thoughts that the Lord has for me, when I looked at the left, I look at the right, to the east, north, south, or west, when I look around myself, I begin to sum up all the thoughts that the Lord has for me. He said they are precious thoughts. All the good thoughts that God has towards us, no one can be able to count the sand. He said, they are more than the thoughts. When I awake, I am still with thee. Hallelujah. Beloved in Christ, whatever you are passing through now, maybe there is no money in the house, there is no job, there is no food, no good health. You thought by now you would have been married. You thought by now you would have been carrying your own children. You thought by now you would have finished that building. And you begin to say to yourself, ah, God does not think good things towards me. The word of God is telling us today. It says, even in all those things that you have programmed to achieve and you have not been able to achieve them, it said, God's thoughts towards us, they are still good and not of evil, to give us an expected end. Hallelujah. Beloved in Christ, the Lord is still able to do it. The Lord has not done it now. Does not mean the Lord will not do it. Does not mean the Lord has forsaken you. Does not mean the Lord does not think good things towards you. The Lord still have you in mind. Let's see what Habakkuk tells us. Habakkuk chapter 2, verses 3. Let's see what he tells us. Beloved in Christ, the Lord is only taking you to pass through a training ground. You are only in your training process. Remember, when you want to climb the staircase, you have to start from the first staircase before you get to the third staircase. Everybody's grades are not the same. Let's see what Habakkuk chapter 2 tells us. Habakkuk 2 verses 3, and it says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. The vision is for yet an appointed time. There is a time that is coming. There is a time that your sun is going to shine. Look at it. It said, but at the end it shall speak and lie. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry again. Hallelujah. Though it tarries, now you are waiting, believing God. All my equals, they are married, they are in their husband's house, they have children. Oh God, I'm a virgin, but I don't have children. I am not married. I went to the university. I am educated. I am enlightened, but nothing good is happening. The Lord says, wait for a moment. Though it tarries, it must surely come to pass. I want to remind us, I'm not comparing problems. I'm not saying that in that situation you are, you should be happy or be rejoicing. But I want to remind you, there are still some people that were born into this earth the same day with you. They are no more. There are still some people in the Socratic home. They just wish, oh God, if you can give me health. There are still some people that are breathing with oxygen. They are just wishing, oh God, if you can help me to leave this hospital, then I can praise you. There are still some people that they cannot walk on their own. They need somebody to be able to hold them before they can walk. Beloved in Christ, Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verses 4 to 5 tells us something. I want you to hold up to that word. What does it say? It said a living dog is better than what? A dead lion. He said there is still hope for the living. There is still hope for the living. Have you ever sat down and asked yourself, why am I still living? Because God, Jehovah El Shaddai, still have good thoughts towards you. Because God still have you in his program. Because God still have you in his plan. That is why you are still living. If not, God would have been on our side, would have been on the grave. The enemies would have eaten us or destroyed us. But God still kept you alive. God still kept me alive. It is for a purpose, because our story is not yet over. The Lord is opening a new chapter for you. And on that day you say, ah, this is God. God has done it. It is not he that started the race first. It is not he that started first. A person can begin the race, and before the end of the race, the person might fall apart. You are still alive, meaning God still have you in mind. Children will come, not just child. I am not talking about the child, but children will come. Riches will come only if you wait upon the Lord. What does the Bible tell us? He said, all things work together for good to them who love God, who are called according to his purpose. Remember what happened to Joseph. The Bible says the brothers of Joseph, they plotted against Joseph and they sold Joseph. They never knew they were taking Joseph to his promised land. They never knew that the Lord is using them as a vehicle to take Joseph to his destined purpose. They never knew the Lord was using them as a staircase for Joseph to be able to get to his position. Because you have decided to wait upon the Lord, you have fasted, you have prayed, you have seek the face of God, you have submitted CV, you have submitted applications, and they keep on promising you, don't worry, I'm going to give you the job. I bring you good news today. They that trust upon the Lord, they shall be like Mount Zion that cannot be moved. Do not trust a man. Man will definitely fail. But God will only use man as a vessel. Keep trusting on the Lord. Seek the face of God and let God reveal to you what you need to do. Be calm. The Lord is able to do it. The Lord is able to change your story for good. Only trust in God and know that the plan and the program of God for you, they are for good. My Bible tells me in John 3:16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. If God Almighty, if Elohim can give his only begotten son for you and for me, for the world to be saved, then what can God not do? God will do it. Your time is coming. Your season is coming. Remember the Bible says, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 7, the gift of God is given to every man according to the grace of God in the life of that person. Your own grace is different from the grace of another person. Do not compare yourself. Do not begin to say, everyone has gotten married. All are married. No, you are not like the other person. Your own case is different, and the Lord is able to change your story. Only focus in God. Do your own part. Do your own part. Do not entertain idleness. Do not entertain laziness. Do your own part, and the Lord is able to perfect the one that is remaining. Having known this, that God has a beautiful plan,
that God have wonderful thoughts, that God have precious purpose for us. I will not also fail to tell us that man has always been a hindrance to God's program or God's desire in their lives. Man has always been an hindrance to God's plan or God's purpose in their life. Let's see what the Word of God tells us in the book of Genesis chapter 2. Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 to 17. I will want us to listen properly. This might also be one of the hindrances why God's plan or purpose towards your life has not come to pass. Hallelujah. Now let's see what the Bible tells us. He said, "And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat." Now, this is God speaking to man. And the Lord said it. Then 17 says, "But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die." Hallelujah. This is one of the hindrances. This is one of the hindrances we are facing as man towards God's plan. God never wished us evil. He never wished us sorrow. But most time, we have always been a source of hindrances to God's plan in our life. Now look at an instruction that God gave to Adam and Eve. What about us today? What about you and I? Most time, the Lord tells us to do a certain thing. We don't do it the way the Lord asks us to do it. We do it the way that suits us. Now, if we do it the way that suits us, then we should get ready for the consequences. God is not a man that should lie. What he says he will do, and what he do is what he will say. If only we can listen to God properly, then the plans of God for our life shall begin to manifest. There are many factors that can hinder God's plan for us. We talked about man, which is an internal factor. We also have other external factors that can hinder God's plan for us. We know that there are forces. The Word of God says, "For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds and to the casting down of every anchor, casting of imagination." This implies that there are forces. We are not ignorant of the devices of the devil. There are forces that we are fighting with. There are a lot of forces. But if we ourselves can be obedient, can be diligently obedient and listen to what God says to us, then we can be able to overcome all other external factors. The Bible says that God will be an enemy to our enemies and be an adversary to our adversary. But the question is, do we listen to God? Even after listening, do we obey what the Lord asks us to do? I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Look at what the Bible tells us in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 7. And the Lord said to Jeremiah, he said, "Jeremiah, even before you were conceived in your mother's womb," this is God speaking, he said, "Jeremiah, even before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou comest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nation." What have the Lord destined for you to be? Did the Lord destine you to be a teacher and you decided to change your mind because you've seen a lot of people go into medical field? Has the Lord called you to be something else and you change your mind? The Lord says, "Jeremiah, I have destined you to be a prophet." And Jeremiah walked according to God's plan in his life, and Jeremiah was successful. Beloved in Christ, it is high time we sit down and ask ourselves what is happening. After all the prayers, God still answers prayers. God still listens to fasting. But the problem most time comes from us as human. I pray the Lord will help us to be able to walk according to God's direction, according to God's skill, according to the program of God in our lives, that we'll be able to achieve God's distinct program in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Please, wherever you are, and you have not yet given your life to Christ, I want to tell us this fact. The word of God is full of principles. If we want to enjoy God's promises in our lives, then we need to walk according to God's principles, God's ordinances. I know that God is a supreme being. He might decide to bless you outside his principles, but we must be honest to ourselves. We must be born again. We must accept Jesus into our life. We must walk in righteousness and holiness. We must make the Holy Spirit to be our friend, and I promise you, our life will not remain the same in the name of Jesus. Amen. And so, Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you for your word that has come forth. My Father, my King, these are the plans you have for us. Plans of good and not of evil, to give us an expected end. I ask, oh God, in any way we have gone astray, in any way we have missed it, Father, show us your mercy. Give us the right spirit. Speak to us, oh God, that we'll be able to walk in accordance with your will and let your purpose in our lives be manifest. Thank you, my Father, for answers to prayer, for in Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen. Still blessed and still served. Hallelujah.